Let's now go on to Paolo, who's in Surrendra in Bonifacio Global City for a taste of exquisite European cuisine. Paolo?
Hey, Gigi, good morning. Well, I know you love it here at Lartizan. Well, I have the pleasure of sharing a very civilized breakfast here with proprietor Johnlu Koa, always the gentleman, to help us understand what Lartizan is all about. Bonjour, good morning.
Bonjour, when you come here in the morning, Paolo, it's bonjour.
Bonjour, indeed, it is a good morning. Well, Johnlu, let's talk about Lartizan. I mean, you introduced really the Filipino palate to European bread and pastries years and years ago through your
French
first
baker.
Enterprise, yes. French baker. And now that we're a little more attuned to what fine European pastries and breads should be like, you've really upped the ante even more and shown us what it can be all about.
Well, Lartizan is all about my life too. When I started French baker 26 years ago, I was much younger.
Yeah.
And now that I have matured, through the years, I realized that the finer things in life, the traditional things in life, are better enjoyed at this age.
Right.
So I'd like, personally, I'd love to use flatware that are made. Like this one is like, if you look at our plate, it's called the Bernardo, the new collection.
Yeah.
We have Christophe, we have silvers all over the place.
Yeah.
It's a place for you to enjoy life when you start your day in the morning.
Right. Well, like I said, you know, it's more than the great coffee, the fine tea, the great breads and pastries. It's the ambiance, the experience. Like you said, you know, the look and feel of good silverware, of fine crystal and that sort of thing, it really completes the experience. I mean, it's not just the food, it's the company and the way that you sort of enjoy these fine things.
It's well, I'd like to position this place as a power breakfast, power lunch, power dinner. I only have like 8 tables,
right.
Actually not much. And it's a quaint and cozy place for people to meet in between meetings or before going to work, after going to work. And here we really have good food. You see, Paolo, my favorites from Paris, they're all here.
Right. What's a typical Parisian what's typical Parisian fare? I mean, like we said earlier, you introduced us to what European breads and pastries are supposed to be like. But what's typical for a Parisian breakfast?
Well, very farmer's type. So whatever is being produced in the farm.
Right.
For example, we have over here. Baked ham and egg.
Look at that. That looks fantastic.
So since the ovens are on the whole night anyways, and then in the morning when you order for that, we have two organic eggs with nicely made smoked ham.
Right.
And we saute fresh mushrooms, not canned mushrooms.
Right.
And then we just gratine in the oven for about 7 to 10 minutes. And it's cooked on a beautiful stove, the cast iron.
Yeah.
The stove brand, S-A-T-A-U-B. And then this is my favorite, œuf à la coque. This is organic egg, just cooked harder than soft boiled.
Okay, it's that sort of perfect in between sort of
That's
egg.
Right. And then these are day old breads that we retoast. It can be in wheat, it can be in sourdough,
right.
It can be in white bread.
So a little slivers of bread that you can dip into your half hard, half soft egg. A selection of beautiful pastries. Yeah. I mean, this is what Lartizan is all about for
me. Kuinaman, for example. This is Kuinaman. This is almond croissant. This would be some nice chocolate muffin. And then we have, in my opinion, best tasting scones.
Now, scones obviously go well with tea and scones, you know.
This is how we serve our tea.
This is how you serve the tea.
Yeah.
Now, tea is a big part of the Lartizan experience. Give us a few pointers on how we should be enjoying our tea. I mean, Lartizan is a salon de thé.
Yeah, here we have Mariage Frère, or Mariage Brothers, if you go to Paris. It's like an iconic brand since 1858. First, you start with the blend. You gotta have a good blend. The lead should be good. Secondly, the infusion time and the temperature of the water.
Right.
For green teas, for example, delicate leaves, we have to do under 80 Celsius. For black tea, we go over 90 Celsius. And for the other infusions, anywhere between 80 and 95.
Right.
So we have peppermint, for example. We have the best chamomile. The whole flower, the whole bud is used. And then what's famous here would be our Earl Greys. There are three types of Earl Grey. We have French Earl Grey, we have English Earl Grey, and then we have the King of Earl Grey.
Right.
They call it Roi de Earl Grey. And then Jasmine Imperial, the favorite among many Pinoys.
Okay. You know, Lartizan is a place where people can come and enjoy, like we keep saying, the finer things in life. Really take the time to sort of enjoy your breakfast. It might be a little intimidating for some people. Do you agree? How would you put people's fears to rest? You know, I don't know if I want to have breakfast there. It's a little intimidating, all this French terms and all these fine things. You know, can anybody come and enjoy?
First of all, the price is not really that intimidating. Mm-hmm. So it's a couple of notches lower than hotel. Mm-hmm. It's not that expensive.
Okay.
Secondly, it's in the neighborhood, Sarandra neighborhood. So.
Right.
We really would like to pamper people who come to this part of town.
Right.
I think what's more important is we've created like a tourist destination kind of a thing.
Okay.
And I would think that our tourists from the other parts of the Philippines, from besides Mindanao, when they come to Manila, they can have a taste of Paris right here. Mm-hmm. And mind you, after breakfast, we have fresh oysters. Mm-hmm. I told you about.
So it doesn't end at breakfast.
And
it's
it
really
comes
just
directly from Paris.
Okay, look at that.
Yeah, and of course, they can look at the bread selection. We are the only authentic sourdough manufacturer in this part of the town.
Well, there's that, you know, that idea of sourdough. It took a while for the Pinoy palate to sort of really adjust to that.
Yes,
it's sour bread, you know.
Well, sourdough is not really sour. Mm-hmm. It's just called sourdough or Louvain in French. When you come here, you see a lot of, all the breads have sourdough. It is the dough that we culture with wild yeast.
Right.
Yeast in the air, yeast in the flour, and some bacteria also in the flour.
Right.
So it's a very intricate process of feeding it with water and flour so that the right taste is achieved.
Right. Well, that's really what Lartizan is all about. As the name implies, it's artisanal.
The artisanal,
bread.
It's by hand,
and a real sort of attention to tradition,
details.
to details and to tradition
yes.
that goes into the breads.
That's right. The breads and pastries and the cakes here are lovable. You can love because it looks different, tastes differently, and above all, it's perfect for gift giving.
Right.
Don't you think so?
That's perfect. Actually, it is the season of giving. Christmas is right around the corner. It's a great gift option, actually.
For this season, we're doing a lot of Christmas stuff. For example, we're doing the usual brioche, but this time brioche, we put some orange peels for Christmas, and then white raisins. Then we also have our traditional Christmas breads, panettone, which we use with two kinds of sourdough. One is the Italian biga sourdough with another French sourdough. And then we also have the other Stollen, which is a very German type of dried fruit bread that can keep for 6 months. And so when they come in, also we have a range of cookies. We have, I think, the widest assortment. Our famous one is the Tuile au Samo, which is a almond tile cookie.
All right,
you can go on and on.
I know. I mean, really, the thing to do is to come out here and, like we say, enjoy a breakfast. And there's also private rooms, private room that you can actually use for your meetings.
And afternoon tea as well. Serve it on beautiful flatware.
Right. Okay. Well, breakfast is really just the beginning here at Lartizan. Drop by, enjoy a great breakfast. If you're lucky, you'll enjoy the company of a true gentleman like Johnlu over here. It's always a pleasure to enjoy civilized company like yourself.
Thank you very much.